If your clipping mask isn't working in Adobe Illustrator, here are a few common fixes. I'm going to try to show you these in the order that I think you might be having the problem. So first is this more complex shape. Now, this is a group of shapes. You can see right up in the corner that it says group. So when you mask something, the top object has to be one object only. So in this case, we have a lot of objects. They're just grouped together. So to have Illustrator see them as one object, we can make a compound path. That's Command 8 or Control 8, or you can come up here and go to Object, Compound Path, Make. And it probably won't change the look of it, but that's okay. I'll just pull it over here, select both, and then hit Command 7 or Control 7. You can also go to Object, Clipping Mask, and Make. And now you are probably going to get the result that you want. The next problem you might be having is that your mask is not on top. So you might have it at the top of a second layer, but it's not at the top of the whole pile. So make sure that your mask is on your top layer, and then hit Shift, Command, and right bracket to bring it to the front. You can also go to Object, Arrange, and Bring to Front. Then put it on top, select both the mask and the image, and then Command 7 or Control 7. And that is the effect we want. Making a clipping mask is the same when you're using raster images, although I wouldn't necessarily recommend using Illustrator for this. It's fine if it's just one or two images. I'll put my mask on the top. I'll select both the mask and the image, and then I'll hit Command 7 or Control 7. Now, I think in older versions of Illustrator, this might not work if this is a linked image. So if it's not working, try embedding the link. Open up your links panel under Window and click on the image, and then choose Embed Images right here. In newer versions, it works okay. Okay, I'm going to release both of those. Now I'm going to try to make a mask with this shape. Now you'll notice I have a fill and a stroke on this, and I want to show you what happens if we just try it as is. I'll bring it to the front, I'll resize it a little bit, and then I'll select both and hit Command 7. Now we actually have a couple problems. First, this is not a compound path, so I'll make it a compound path with Command 8 or Control 8. And now let's try it. I'll bring it to the front and Command 7 or Control 7. Now, it did work, but it doesn't look the same. We want it to go all the way out to the edges here. And what's happening is it's ignoring our stroke. So I'm going to undo, I'll put it back, and now I need to expand this so that the shape goes all the way out to the edge. So I'll go to Object, Expand, and we'll do both fill and stroke, and we'll say OK. Now I'll come over here to the Pathfinder and unite this. So now we have just one shape. It goes all the way out to the edges. We can put this on top of our image, select both, and then mask it that way. Another couple things to avoid. If your mask shape is transparent or if it has an effect like a gradient, it might not work the way you want. So if that is causing an issue, just remove those things or expand them. Another thing that might cause an issue, although I've never run into this, is that your image may have masks already inside it. Normally this will still work, but I read online that sometimes that could cause an issue. So try to release those masks first if it's not working the way you want. All right, I hope this video was helpful. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.